Hi everyone, I am Dr. Soundara Raj. I am very happy to interact with you all through this video. In this video, I am going to take you through a concept titled Push versus Pull Strategies. These are all a few details related to my career. After you watch the full video, if you find the video beneficial to you, give a like to the video and do subscribe my channel so that you will get the notifications of my future videos. Push versus Pull Strategies, which could otherwise be called as promotion mix strategy. Marketers can choose from two basic promotion mix strategies. They are push strategy and pull strategy. The relative emphasis on the specific promotion tools differs for push and pull strategies. The procedure to be followed by a company or a marketer for following push strategy is entirely different from that of the situation where the same company follows pull strategy for promoting its marketing offer. What is the meaning of push strategy? It refers to the promotion strategy that calls for using the sales force and trade promotion to push the product through the channels. The producer promotes the product to channel members who in turn promote it to the final consumers. This is a popular strategy being practiced by companies which are promoting imitative products or the brands which are not popular. Perhaps I would say this is a popular strategy being practiced by companies which are not really familiar among the consumers or in the market. This is a very successful strategy for promoting less popular brands. In this strategy, the marketers motivate the channel intermediaries, motivate the sales force to make the product available in the market, and also financially supports the channel intermediaries to promote the marketing offer with their customers. So in order to recommend a company's product, definitely the channel intermediaries are expecting a higher profit margin from the companies which depend upon pushing strategy. So here, the products are pushed by the channel intermediaries into the hands of the final consumers. The second strategy is known as pull strategy. It is a strategy that calls for spending a lot on advertising and consumer promotion to induce final consumers to come forward to buy the product. This creates a demand vacuum that pulls the product through the channel. So obviously, this is a popular promotion strategy being followed by most popular companies in every product market. The popular companies, through their marketing communication, specifically in the form of advertising, sales promotional tools targeted upon the final consumers, they pull the consumers to the retail counters and demand for the marketing offers of the companies. So obviously, it is the job of channel intermediaries to give away the products that are demanded by the consumers. So there is no role for the channel intermediaries to promote the products which are promoted by companies using pulling strategies, because the consumers are pulled by the companies directly to the channel intermediaries and demand for their favorite brands in any product category they prefer to. So this is about the second promotion mix strategy. The next concept to be discussed in this video is important factors to be considered in designing promotion mix strategies. There are quite a lot of aspects available as factors to be considered in designing promotion mix strategy. However, I have identified two important factors that I am going to explain now. Number one, type of product or market. The importance of different promotion tools varies between consumer and business markets. Business to consumer companies usually pull more, putting more of their funds into advertising, followed by sales promotion, personal selling, and then public relations. In contrast, business to business marketers tend to push more, putting more of their funds into personal selling, followed by sales promotion, advertising and public relations. You could find the change in the order of priority given for different promotional tools in the two strategies. In general, personal selling is used more heavily with expensive and risky goods and in markets with fewer and larger sellers. The second factor to be considered in designing promotion mix strategies is product life cycle stage. The effects of different promotion tools also vary with the stages of the product life cycle. In the introduction stage, advertising and public relations are good for producing high awareness, and sales promotion is useful in promoting early trial of the products. Personal selling must be used to get the trade to carry the product. In the growth stage of the product, advertising and public relations continue to be powerful influences, whereas sales promotion can be reduced because fewer incentives are needed. In the maturity stage of the product, buyers know the brands and advertising is needed only to remind them of the product. In the decline stage, which is supposed to be the last stage of a product in its life cycle, advertising is kept as a reminder level. Public relations is dropped and salespeople give the product only a little attention. Whereas you find sales promotion is heavily used as a promotional tool for disposing the product which is about to die in its life cycle. Thanks for watching this video. I hope I have done my explanation up to your satisfaction. If you like the video, give a like to the video and do subscribe my channel. Thanks for your time to watch this video. Bye for now, everyone.